Come.
Is on my side.
Yes, it is.
Time is on my side.
Yes, it is.
Now you always say that you want to be free, but you come running back. You come running back. Why you keep
And now back to our stage from England, the Rolling Stones.
Well, I told you once and I told you twice. You never listen to my advice. Don't try very hard to please me. But you know it should be easy. Well, this could be the last time. This could be the last time. Maybe the last time. I don't know. Oh, no. Oh, no. Well, I'm sorry, girl, but I can't sleep. Feeling like I do. I'll feel the same tomorrow. Well, this could be the last time. This could be the last time. Maybe the last time. I don't know. Oh, no. Oh, no. Someone have to pay the price. Here's a chance to change your mind. Cause I'll be gone a long, long time. Well, this could be the last time. This could be the last time. Maybe the last time. I don't know. Oh, no.
Tonight, the Ed Sullivan Show has been brought to you by Easy On Spray Starch, with a special formula that will not scorch, leaves your iron shining clean, free from starch buildup. Easy On. And by Pillsbury, where news in baking begins. Pillsbury's best.
welcome on command. I'm glad you are a monkey.
In a past life, he was himself. If opportunity knocks and he's not home, opportunity waits. He gave his father the talk. He is the most interesting man in the world.
I don't always drink beer, but when I do, I prefer Dos Equis. Stay thirsty, my friend.
Under my coat, she's out of these. My friend Larry Cogdill died last Saturday. I've known Larry since 1980. I met him when I was going to school at Grossmont College. I took a Spanish class and there was this surfer-looking dude sitting next to me. That was Larry. I didn't say anything to him. I was a new kid, just in from Palm Springs. And I just sort of checked everything and everyone out. I was about 20 years old. So I'm sitting in Spanish class, and there was this pretty girl named Karen who was sitting in front of Larry. She had her hair in a bun, and Larry had a number 2 pencil in his hand. He looked over at me and said, "Shh." He then took the pencil and stabbed the bun of her hair, and the pencil was stuck in it. Well, Karen didn't feel the pencil, and she was moving her head around and answering questions in Spanish that the teacher was asking. The pencil was sticking out of the side of her hair bun and moving around. She had no idea. Well, this is about the funniest thing I'd seen all day. I started shaking with laughter. The kind of laughter where you don't want to laugh, but you can't stop. In fact, I was laughing so hard that I fell out of my chair and landed on the floor. The Spanish teacher was pissed. He said, "Esteban, what are you doing?" I couldn't even answer him because now I was crying with laughter. The kind of laughter that doesn't stop for anything or anyone. It's an affliction I've had since birth. So the Spanish teacher says, "Miss Karen, tú tienes un lápiz en tu pelo." It's probably not exactly what he said, and my Spanish is bad, but it basically means you have a pencil in your hair. This put me over the top, and Larry just had a bemused look on his face watching me, and the Spanish teacher told me I had to leave. He kicked me out of the class that day. I now had tears coming out of my eyes with hysterical, nervous laughter. Karen took the pencil out of her hair and Larry followed me out of the class. We waited outside for the last 10 minutes of class and we introduced ourselves to each other. Then Karen came out and looked at us like the idiots we were. Then Larry said, "Do you guys have fake IDs? Let's go get a beer." So the three of us went and got drunk. Lots of laughs. That was the beginning of a wild ride. I'd just moved to San Diego in 79 and was getting acclimated to college life. Larry was a San Diegan through and through. He was best friends with this guy named Mark Johnson. They were both blonde California surfers, and they took me under their guidance and brought me surfing. We surfed all the time. We'd go to 7th Street in Del Mar and hike down the cliff. We'd go to Mexico. We'd go to the Salvation Army and buy cool shirts. That's what Larry called them. Cool shirts, short sleeve polyester button-ups with colored stripes and long straight collars. We'd wear them with faded Levi's and Converse low-top tennis shoes. Larry ended up transferring to UCSB in Santa Barbara. He lived in Goleta, and I'd come up from San Diego to visit him. I had transferred to San Diego State, so I'd drive up for Halloween. It was insane there back in those days in Goleta. Sometimes I'd drive up just to hang, and we'd go to concerts in Santa Barbara. I remember one time we saw all three of these bands on the same bill: The Police, XTC, and Oingo Boingo, in the gym at UCSB for $5. Nutso McGutso. I remember we met a couple girls one night at a party, and they were both named Tammy. So we had this rhythm we'd pound out on the wall before we went to sleep, and it went da 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 da. It meant Larry loves Tammy, Steve loves Tammy. I'm reading this so you can hear it and hear the rhythm. I could do this rhythm even 35 years later, and he'd immediately start chanting the words. I'm not really sure why I'm telling you guys all of this. I just don't want to forget it. I wasn't as close to Larry as time went on, but he was always in my thoughts, and we stayed in touch. You know how time marches on? Part of it was that I quit drinking 18 years ago, and Larry never stopped. This dude was a champion drinker, funny as all get out. It's just that when you give up booze, sometimes you need to distance yourself from hard partiers because it's not as fun when you're not wasted. But we'd always run into each other, and it was certainly a good time. I just spoke with him a month ago after his heart surgery. He was born with a poor ticker, and I think he knew his time was limited. Last Friday, he checked himself out of the ER ward because his heart was beating irregular. I think he knew he was going to die and he didn't want to be in a hospital. He died at home. I feel sad, I feel blue, yet I'm happy that he's free. I miss him already. He was larger than life and the most generous guy I've ever met. And loud and funny. He was kind of like Rodney Dangerfield. When he'd see me, he'd say, "Buddy man!" That's what we called each other. Then we'd sing a song we made up that went, "Buddy man, buddy man, bud, bud, buddy man, buddy man, buddy man, bud, bud, buddy man, buddy man." Very silly, but I want you to know this. Otherwise, no one will. I could go on and on. You guys didn't know him, and he didn't want a funeral. But I want you to know that I loved him. God bless.
He is the most interesting man in the world.
Stay thirsty, my friends.
Jack and I love spending time with Uncle Larry, and we miss him. This song goes to Uncle Larry.
Oh, Larry, everybody, let him hear it. Come on, Larry. Show us how it's done.
I met a gentle bar of Queen in Memphis. She tried to take me upstairs for a ride. She had to heave me right across her shoulder.
Come on, man.
I just can't seem to drink it off my mind. Wow, guitar woman. Give me the honky tonk blues. I later divorced in New York City. I had to pull out a sock kind of a fight. She blew my nose and then she blew my mind. The honky-tonk guitar woman. Give me the honky-tonk blues.
Come on, Keith. Let's switch you on now. Oh yeah.
Give me the honky tonk blues.
You all know the words to this.
Honky tonk woman. Give me, honky tonk blues.
Woo!
We're the folks on the lights of the world. Larry, everybody, make some noise for Larry. Let him hit.